Hello, hello, hello.
Hi everyone. It's a blustery cool day.
Yep.
On the island.
In Bowser.
Yeah, we're at my place today.
Yeah, we switched up, thought I'd drive down and have a little chat.
I was hoping that it was going to be, I'm just going to get you in the picture a bit more. I was hoping that it was going to be a nice sunny day. We could sit on the deck or something.
I know.
Oh well.
Praying for sunshine.
Yeah, we'll do that another time. Yeah.
And we're in April.
I know.
What is the date today?
15th? 15th? Is it the 15th, I think?
No.
No. I think it's the 17th. I think it's the 17th.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
17th. Yeah. Losing track of time. Like, we were talking about this earlier about babies that are 3 years old already, because it seems like time stood still for like 3 years.
Yeah. Or they're in kindergarten. It's just like, weren't they just walking?
Yeah. Yeah.
What do you mean they're in kindergarten? They're walking?
Yeah. Or just seeing somebody on the street that had a baby just seemed like just yesterday, and then already sitting up and walking around. I have a friend at work, well, at Alan's work, and he had a baby 3 months ago, and this baby is walking. Like, it's crazy. Like, his legs are probably going to bowl because his bones aren't strong enough
he's
for him.
He's walking.
And he's walking.
Oh, smart now.
He is walking. It's like
Corrine.
Aliens are being born. I don't know.
Corrine. Are you kidding me?
No, it's true.
The baby's walking at 3 months old.
Yes. Yes. He didn't want to crawl at all, this baby. And he hates being on his back or on his belly. Like, if you lay him down, that's what he was saying. But this, it's crazy, right?
Holy smokes.
Yeah. Amazing.
I love to see it. I know. I had a girlfriend that's baby walked at 6 months, and that was many, many years ago. And this little guy was walking around, and we're like,
he
shouldn't be walking, but I can't imagine a three-month-old.
No, because they're not very stable, and their bones are
soft,
right?
Yeah, they'll have to massage them.
That's what he was doing, right? Massaging his legs after he wants to walk.
Oh my goodness, anyway. That's just something else.
Yeah.
I'd love to see that.
Yeah, just growing up too fast, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So anyways, what we're on today is to talk about all the stuff, all the candy. How about that? We'll use candy as an example of, what's in the candy for these little kids that are just going completely crazy, especially after Easter.
Easter, oh yeah. I'm going crazy myself, but
right?
It's because I eat too much chocolate.
All the sugar and all the stuff that's going on and all these kids that are just all over the place, right? But, and this is just, also, I want to, say that I am not a doctor by any means of the imagination, but it's something to look into of what is containing in the candies that these little kids are eating, especially your red dyes. And then we talked about the yellow dyes and the blue dyes and all this kind of stuff. I was watching this lady that was on
TED Talks, I think, hey? She was doing a TED Talk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she just kind of brought something to my attention. And she's a psychologist.
Psychologist, yeah.
Yeah, she's got her degree and everything. But she had a child that was healthy and, just a regular little guy. And she started seeing some changes in him at the age of 7. And what had happened was, I guess he was diagnosed with
ADHD.
ADHD, and didn't know, why. The doctor didn't put him on anything, but which is a good thing. But she continued to watch him spiral, and this little guy was basically telling her that, he wasn't feeling right, and she started noticing his behavior and everything getting a little wonky. And lo and behold, find out that, she took him off of Red Dot.
Yeah, from the candy. I should go get my package of candy.
From Red Dot, right? That was the beginning of the story here. And because he was starting to tell his mom that his brain was buzzing. And she goes, brain's buzzing, right? What do you mean, right? So she started looking into things a little more, you know, more in depth, and ended up taking him off of this red dye. And he was good for what? 7 months, did she say?
Yes, 7 months.
He was good for about 7 months, and then she said that he was eating stuff like yellow dyes and stuff, and stuff. They went to Hawaii and they were putting this artificial pineapple stuff on the ice, and you know, so he was, yeah, whatever. And then he started spiraling again after 7 months, and this time it was even worse because he was telling her that he didn't want to.
He wanted to die. He didn't want to live anymore. Yeah.
This is a 7-year-old kid.
Yeah.
So what we're basically saying is, you know, starting to notice some changes in your children, that they're just not acting right, and they're, you know, disrupting the class, and they're not paying attention. They're kind of all over the map, and you're seeing this. You know, I would definitely look into what their diets are,
yeah,
and what they're feeding, because all the stuff that's out there right now. I'm not just talking about, you know, candy. I'm talking about all sorts of stuff.
Anything's processed,
yeah,
foods, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like, for instance, this, you know, I was reading this earlier. It's like there's all kinds of different colors of the candy in this, and I don't want to put the name on there, but it says lemon and grape and strawberry and orange and lime. And when you look at the ingredients, it doesn't, it says artificial flavors. And natural, but there's ingredients like Allura Red, Indigo Carmine, Sunset Yellow, Brilliant Blue FCF, Sunset Yellow FCF. So those are actually called ingredients. Like those are like colors to me. So what are these colors? Like, it's, you got to question everything when you read ingredients. And even I was looking at something about citric acid. You got to look that up, because I heard that there's actually mold.
Yes.
In,
right?
The citric acid. It's not really lemons. Like, they're saying it's lemon. It isn't. So it's, you can be deceived by what they tell you is in here that may not actually be what it is. And weird names that you can't even say. Right? Like,
exactly.
What is it? Processed foods, right? You don't know what it's made of.
No.
But it's gluten-free and gelatin-free.
That's why they put that little natural in there too, right? So it's just something that I think people should, you know, mothers should be concerned about, and what's actually being put in this food. And you're, especially if you're starting to notice that your beautiful children are being affected by this, you know, because we just assume that everything that we buy off the shelves that have all been checked out, and, you know, well, they're not. So
yeah.
Make sure that you, you know, take a look at exactly what's going into your kids' diet and stuff. Anyways, right? Even ourselves, we have to watch when you really start to look at the big picture, you know, when people are feeling weird or feeling funny, it could be possibly something that your body's telling you and saying to you that stay away from this.
Yeah. Well, it's pretty sad when you have to read ingredients, and that's when you know you're actually on a processed food aisle, because if it doesn't look like a grapefruit, it isn't a grapefruit. But you have pasta noodles that I actually really even read the ingredients and pastas, because it's a processed, it doesn't look like flour anymore or egg or whatever. So, and you can't read it and you don't know what it is. Do you still buy it, or do you look it up on your phone, and is it going to be accurate information? Because we all know that the internet sometimes tells you stuff that isn't true, So you kind of really gotta
watch. Yeah, you gotta, you have actually, you know what, your best bet to do is just to be able to educate yourself. You don't have to listen to Corey and I. Basically, exactly. Just educate yourself and take a look for yourself to see what's actually going on out there with ingredients and stuff.
Yeah.
For your little ones. Because this one here was just a real eye-opener when I seen that. Because no child at 7 years of age is going to be saying to you that he wants to, you know.
Yeah.
It's, yeah. It it's just such a scary thought that, you know, the turmoil that they're actually going through because of an ingredient that doesn't agree with our kids.
Yeah.
That is being put in there, yeah. Right? So.
Yeah, like how many kids have you gone to the grocery store and they're at the cash register and that's where all the chocolate bars are and they're having a temper tantrum, mm-hmm. because they can't have a candy. Like, and I know when I eat sugar, I crave sugar. So yes. I know what that feeling's like, and it's in, they're insistent about it, and they actually get angry, right?
They get mad and
emotional about it. Yeah. And
well, we were talking about that earlier. You know, you make a thing of cookies, for instance, chocolate chip cookies.
Yeah.
Well, you got all these chocolate chip cookies. It's only Chris and I, and all of a sudden. Unless we have a cookie monster in the house, who's eating all the cookies? Do you know what I'm saying? And they're gone in 2 days.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a lot of sugar. And because the more you take, the more you want. It's like your body can't say no because it's sugar. And sugar is one of the biggest, what would you call it?
Addictions.
Addiction.
Yeah.
And you don't even realize it. And then the next time you do it, you know, you're sitting there watching TV or you're doing whatever, and all of a sudden something goes, bing. Oh, what do I have? And you're thinking in your head, what do I have that's sweet?
Yeah. Let alone the commercials that are showing you all this food while you're watching TV. But
it's just so addicting. Like, there's got to be something sweet in the house.
And you know, like eating the whole batch is a thing. I got to get rid of it. I gotta eat it, and then it's gone, and I'm done.
Right?
Until the next batch.
Oh my goodness. I don't eat a lot of candy, but there's one candy that I really do like, and that is, what do you call those chewy ones? The
Eat More?
No, they're like a candy. They're in a roll.
Toffee? Oh, Tootsie Roll.
No, they're not chocolate. Oh. They're just a gum.
Gummy? Oh.
What do you call those?
Jelly something.
Wine gum.
Oh, okay.
I love wine gums, and they're so addictive. So I'm really careful that I don't bring those in the house. They were on for 99 cents a package.
Oh my god!
So what did I do? About 4 or 5.
You ate them.
And I did.
See?
Yeah.
You gotta get rid of them.
So it's what I'm an adult, so you can imagine these kids, right? Especially through Easter and Christmas, and
there's always sugar components.
There's always just sugar component to be, you know,
isn't that interesting?
Pushing it on and what have you. So,
Why? It's a thing. Yeah. Well, I know I did the keto diet like 4 years ago, and I started in the spring, and I was feeling absolutely amazing, and then came into the Christmas season, and I thought, well. It's just Christmas. I'll just cheat. I got to bake because the whole family's there.
Yeah.
And it knocked me right off the diet.
Yeah. And
you're back haven't recovered.
The same turmoil.
Haven't recovered.
Right? It's kind of weird when you really, really think about how addicting it is, and it's everywhere. It's in everything.
Well, then you can notice that kids' behavior when they eat a sweet. Because I noticed that with my granddaughter and my grandson. When they would have it, their temperament changed immediately after finishing it. And it's like, and you know, they would say, no, it's not the sugar.
It's the sugar.
You can tell a difference, right? So if it's affecting us, you know, and it's sad that this child is suicidal because of the I think it's because of the buzzing that he was getting in his brain. He called it buzzing in his brain.
So he told his mom. He says, my brain's buzzing.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
I remember one time when my grandson Jackson, when he was quite small, he was at my mom's place. My mom was his grandma, his great grandma, and it's actually kind of cute, really. But my mom would give him some candy. And I think he's probably about 3 years old. And he goes, now I'm going to go really crazy, he says. So he told my mom, I go,
oh my God.
Now I'm going to go really crazy because, you know, he hears too that don't give him any candy because he goes crazy, right?
Yeah.
So my mom says, well, I guess if you're going crazy, I guess you're going to be going to bed. And then he's like, I'm just joking, you know, but.
Yeah.
We laughed our heads off when we heard that. Now I'm going to go really crazy.
Yeah. No,
but it's true. You see kids, you know, Jackson's bouncing around at Christmas time, you know, couldn't sit still. Well, then we find out he ate one of those
Toblerone things.
Yeah. Like this, it was gone. Like,
yeah.
What do you expect?
Yeah.
If it's there, they're going to eat it.
Yeah. And they say actually sugar stops that reflex where you know you're full. You just don't get full on sugar. You just don't. You just keep, it's your brain, right?
Exactly. So, and I love those Rice Krispie squares.
Oh, God.
Oh, I could eat a can of Krispie
squares. Oh, you got to go to Coombs. Oh, it was there on the weekend. Sorry, off track.
That's
but
okay.
They had a big sheet wrapped Rice Krispie square. Like, it had the Rice Krispie square packaging in this foil wrap, and it's a sheet
long
Rice Krispie squares.
Right.
Anyway.
It's got to come fresh for me. Like,
yeah.
Right, you know when you pull it apart and it's still gooey?
Yeah. Puff wheat squares, too, for me, because there's
goodness.
Chocolate in there.
Oh, my goodness. See?
And we're adults.
We got to stop the sugar craze. And you know, the thing is, when you do go off of sugar, I've done it many times. Went back onto the sugar, but after probably a good couple of weeks, you don't crave it anymore.
You don't.
Your cravings stop. You don't. You're not thinking about it. You're not going, geez, is there a chocolate bar around the house here? You just basically carry on. But as soon as you introduce yourself again, like I said, with sugar, you're back. You're completely off the saddle again.
Well, and the thing is that in processed food, there's sugar hidden in everything.
Yep.
If you were to look at how many grams of sugar is in everything, there's sugar in almost everything, but not the same concentration as what you'd get from a candy bar or candies and stuff like that.
There's sugar in.
But still.
It's in bread.
Yeah.
Carbohydrates are just loaded with sugar.
Yeah.
You know, there's the good one, and then there's the you know, flour, for instance. Turns to sugar in our, you know,
in your body,
in your blood right away, right? So
everybody's pancreas must be twitching, really.
Oh my goodness! Right.
Like, you noticed a difference going off gluten, even.
Yes.
Like, did you know? What did you notice? Like, more brain clarity, more.
Mm-hmm.
Like, lots of people are doing that, and I'm starting to introduce it here and there because Kristen is gluten free too, so. But the bloating and all that stuff,
goodness.
Right?
The bloating. Okay, so for instance, that's what my problem was. It seemed like every time I was eating spaghetti, like, I'm not a real huge pasta person anyways, but say if I had made spaghetti, well, I could have like this much spaghetti, right? Not over the top spaghetti, but enough. And probably about 10 minutes after I ate it, I could feel, and this is no word of a lie, my stomach would go, oof.
Wow.
Oof. I looked like I was 9 months pregnant, and I'm not exaggerating.
So it felt uncomfortable?
It was very uncomfortable. I felt full, stuffed like I'd ate in a big, great, big, huge turkey dinner. Mm. And it just kind of started like that. So I had to feel my own body, what was going on. What is it that every time I eat something, why am I feeling that? And it pretty much was going on with hormone changing, right?
Oh, yeah.
So that's when I really noticed it. Mm-hmm. And so I just started taking out the flour out of my system. And I everything just kind of went.
Yeah. Crazy. Yeah.
I mean, I look like a chipmunk. I could show you a picture, remember?
I didn't think you looked like a chipmunk.
Oh, my goodness, I did. My sister pointed it out one day. That was probably, I gotta think here, probably coming on to 4 years ago, there was a picture of me, because my mom's got pictures all over her house of everybody, and this picture of me in particular, I literally look like a chipmunk. And I'm not joking. I mean, I've already got, you know, my cheeks, right? It was the heaviest I've ever been in my life. And when I seen that picture, I was like this.
Wow, eh?
It was unbelievable.
Yeah.
And that was gluten.
Do I have chipmunk cheeks? Because I love pasta.
But you might not be allergic to it.
Maybe not.
But you know what? It doesn't affect you.
Well, yeah.
Your body's digesting it properly. With me, it wasn't digesting.
No, I feel full when I eat, but I eat too much pasta. Like when I have pasta, it's
and you're only supposed to have a fistful, people. This is, they say, the portion.
That's your stomach size.
Of your meat and your way. You're not supposed to have it like.
I must have been starving when I was a child.
Must have. I used to eat spaghetti when I was young, and I remember being full, but not this.
It's different.
Not uncomfortable.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So I kind of turned it around and pretty much not 100% gluten free, but I'm pretty much there. And sometimes I've been cheating, but I've learned how to cook gluten free. And it's pretty easy. You just don't put when you shop. You just don't put that in your buggy. You don't have it totally
in your house.
In your house. You know.
Well, I have to get that recipe you just talked about, the baked spaghetti using rice noodles.
Yes, rice
because
noodles.
I love pasta. Mm-hmm. And I know I could lose some weight, and that's probably, pasta is not a good thing.
Well,
when
you can
you're
also
to lose weight.
You can also do zucchini. You know, if you have a zucchini,
oh, yeah.
You can do zucchini
shredded
noodles.
Yeah,
and you
yeah.
Just shred it up and put and everything
you
that you
that.
Put in
yes,
there.
Yes, that's true.
Right?
Yeah.
For spaghetti squash.
Yes.
Too.
Spaghetti
yeah.
squash is another one, right?
Yeah.
There's so many alternatives, right? To
and it's not processed, you know, it looks like a spaghetti
exactly,
squash.
Right.
Spaghetti squash. Or a zucchini. Yeah.
But it's just it's hard. It takes 30 days to break a habit.
Yeah.
That's what they say. 30 days to end up breaking a habit, and after that you're clear sailing. It's because that stuff, and drink tons of water, because when you're going through anything like sugar or trying to break a habit of anything, you're supposed to be drinking tons of water, flushing your body, flushing it out.
I wonder, like sometimes, I can't remember what I was reading, but they talked about sometimes when you're grabbing for something to eat, it's actually because you're thirsty.
Mm-hmm.
You're dehydrated, and I think most people are dehydrated, and I have a hard time getting enough water. Like I can get 4 cups in it, maybe 6 a day.
No, that's pretty good.
Taking my vitamins and stuff, but
well, this time of the year we are dehydrated because it's not sunny out. We're not sweating. Our top lips aren't sweating.
Yes, yet, and we're drinking coffee or having salt in our foods, which dehydrate. Like our organs are probably just ready to kick our butt sometimes.
Right. But in the summertime, we're gulping bath water, right?
Or
other things. Right? But it's just little tiny baby steps. You don't have to go jump on board or whatever. But I think the reason we ended up getting onto the subject was to do with your kids.
Yeah.
And to see what's going on, if you've been noticing some changes, or even change up a little bit with them and not be throwing all the sugar around like it's, you know, okay, because it's not.
Yeah. Yeah, and these processed lunch meals that kids bring to school, right? It's easy peasy. for mom to make the lunches, but it's better to get back to more wholesome foods.
Yeah.
As much as we can.
As much as we can. And yeah. I know we're all busy, but you know what?
Yeah.
Little changes here and there, and educating yourselves to understand what we've talked about here. Like I said, we're not doctors, but we are. I've done a little bit of research on certain little things in my life through just
yourself,
searching for myself as well to understand a little bit about proper etiquette of eating and then to consume what's in your diets.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I cook everything from scratch.
Yeah. Yeah, so. it's like question everything.
Yeah.
Read ingredients.
I'm in the odd time, yeah. But I don't buy it. Maybe the odd time I might go get a pizza. And it's usually gluten. I've made tons of gluten-free pizza.
Yeah.
Whatever, right?
So. Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
So anyways.
Okay. Well, hopefully this
was
helpful.
Yeah. That was just a little quick little.
Yeah.
I hope everybody's doing good. Great. And I don't know where you guys are. Hopefully it's sunny where you are because it's cold.
Yeah.
Waiting for our sunshine.
Yeah. Get more sunshine and warmth.
Right.
Yeah.
Anyways, keep shining.
Yeah. Take care, guys.
Bye.
Bye.